here we are. We're in the present day El Ciclo, and we are exploring for the sake of a fragment now, not just story. There's a book entitled La Torre de la Aura. Cecily takes herself to the next one. To the average person, the only time that exists is the present, but in fact, there are parallel worlds and portals to places where time behaves differently indeed. There's only one word for those of us who are able to intuitively sense all that is not as it seems when it comes to time. Geniuses. Okay, so that's the same book from earlier. I came to this town to research the life and work of El Maestro Señor Pomposo. But still, there's a vital piece of the puzzle missing. Just who was the mother of Pomposo's daughter, Antonina? No matter how many times I pore over, I seem no closer to the truth. The man who used to own this house was a doctor by the name of Salvador. He must have known something. If only he had left some kind of clue somewhere. But if he did, I'm afraid I can't, for the life of me, find it. Did you not search the bookshelf? I mean, if it's been centuries... I'm renting some studio space to the young man in the basement. He's trying to become an artist. But now that I think about it, El Maestro himself once used that room. Perhaps I should charge him more. What? Because somebody else used that apartment room? No, fuck off. Oh, look at that, a green fragment. Take it. It's mine. Hey, holy water. Sassy finds an old letter stuck in between the pages of a book. Quiero, Salvador, by the time you read this letter, I will already be gone. I have been sick for so very long. I knew this day would come. My only fear is for my daughter's future. I cannot stand the thought of her becoming a burden to him, so I have not told her the truth about her father. You're my oldest friend and the only person I can rely upon. I beg you, please look after Mia Hija. I know I'm asking a lot of you, but I hope that you will grant my final wish. Your friend forever, Amelia. Pocket the letter? Yeah. Can you believe it? This room was once used by the great Pomposo. I wonder if the work I do here will also be touched by the spark of his genius. I sure hope so. The painting of Pomposo's clock tower. If only El Salvador had left some kind of letter to hint at the identity of Antonio's mother. Hmm? What's that? You found the letter downstairs. Perhaps this is the evidence we need. Please, you must let me take a look. Thank you, I'm very grateful to you, Newt. Now, let me quickly read through it. There can be no doubt about it. This is clearly a letter from Antonio's mother to Salvador. Let me see, according to this letter, her name was Amelia. Simply knowing her name marks a huge leap forward in my research. And to think, the key to unlocking all this was right under my nose all along. Well, I'm exceedingly grateful to you. I'm suddenly feeling much more optimistic about my work. I'd like to give you a little something to thank you. Here, take the Seed of Wisdom. Good answer. Sasa receives the Seed of Wisdom. Alright. Well, whatever. Let's go into the weapon shop, see what they have for sale there. Welcome to the armor shop. How can I serve you? What would you like to buy? Oh, I actually want that shield. Before I buy my character a shield, let's check what this guy's got. 16, we have Steel Broad Sword, Steel Fangs, Iron Axe, Cautery Sword. I actually already have the Cautery Sword, so. There we go. Got myself a Platinum Shield. I'm glad Maribel can actually equip the platinum stuff, or the magic stuff, though. Well, at least the magic shield. She may not be able to equip the magic armor. I hope she can. You know, it's true that there are a lot of weird buildings in this town, but if you ask me, there are even more weird people. I can't really make out head or tails of them, to be honest, the people or the buildings. Well, we found our fragments, so now we're just gonna go around, search, talk to people, see how things have changed. Mi hombre, he's saying all sorts of crazy things. It's the loco. Is he crazy, you think? Who wants to see him with his clothes off? Natty, no one. Ah, sucks for you, buddy. See, I am a sculptor, but I am tired of working in stone. My new goal is to sculpt myself. Behold. My musculature is Miss Magnifica. Look at my amazing body. My dream is to win the Tuffy Trophy and be acknowledged around the world for my unparalleled physique. Well, apparently your wife does not agree. I feel like her input is somewhat important on the matter. Bienvenidos, welcome to the headquarters of EGO, the Excellence Grading Organization. Phil, how can I help you today? I don't really want to enter right now. So. See, as we get older, our beauty fades and our strength declines. Así es la vida, such is life. But there is one thing that only grows as we get older. No, not our nose hair. Our wisdom, our minds. In mi opinión, I believe it is not too much to say that our true value lies in the content and quality of our brains. So my advice to you is not to worry solely about your strength or your appearance, but also take time to feed your mind. Este claro? The reigning champion, the numero uno for style and beauty, has not changed for many, many years. Si, es verdad. It is true, decades ago she claimed the top spot, and no challenger has been able to unseat her since. Ah, Becca. Ah, Basis. Just sometimes I wonder where Greta is right at this moment, what she is doing. Oi! I would love to meet her just once so I could ask her how she stayed at the top for so long. Power, strength, muscle, physique. It's muy important. Para number. Is important for a man? But in this world, women cannot afford to be weak either. No, como se dice. How you say? You gotta be so macho. Well, come, I want you to see. I want to see you sweat. I want to see feel the burn. Grahaha! The glossy publication titled Style Tips of the Stars, Issue 1, as it turns to a feature on the ABCs of accessorizing. The key to looking slick and stylish is to equip armor and weapons of the same type. What better way to bring out the cult sultry sparkle of your platinum sword than to coordinate with a matte and platinum male headgear and shield? So it's kind of tips on how to win these best dress contests. We only use this room when the new number 1 takes the place at the top of the rankings. Might look big and empty barn right now, but it'll be packed to the rafters when the time comes. That's right, maybe one day on stream I'll do the side content for later. Right now this game has so much going on and just the story along to worry about any of that. Ciclo was once the home of the famed Narticatergo, Senor Pomposo. Now it calls itself home of talent and ambition, and people have started coming to it to todo el mundo from all over the world. But what I can see, it's not a single one of them is worthy of comparison to El Maestro. Not yet. Give them time, though, bud. I crossed this big bridge to get here. It was so full of hustle and bustle. It was so alive with all the people coming and going. It was great. Nothing special. A pretty Betsy. I'm hanging on to the pretty Betsy's all so I can give them to one person for the style contest later. unos, dos, tres, quechua! Yo soy bonita, yo soy guapa. Oi, what are you doing? I did not say you could listen. Well, too bad. A trailblazing bandana. I don't think this is good. Do I know where Greta is? Not a clue. This is weird tower off to the east here. Apparently it was called El Monumento de Pomposo, but it was the last work of some master builder or other. This is just so weird. On the inside is it on the outside, and it's full of tricks and traps and that. You seen that big mansion on the edge of town? Well, apparently this millionaire took one look at it and bought it. Now he's got this amazing holiday home, but apparently he's far too busy to ever visit it. Seems a bit of a waste to me. What leaderboard is an absolute disgrace. Where's the justice, I ask you? Am I just meant to believe that I wasn't even in the top 30? It's unthinkable. No, if I'm not vying for the top of the charts, there's clearly something wrong with the criteria being used. A monument to the Pomposo has many devices inside it to stop intruders from reaching its highest heights. It's incredible. It was built centuries ago, but they say no one has ever reached to the top. It seems there's no end to the talents of El Maestro. The other day, I came across the bridge to the north of here. There was a place selling herbal tea, whatever that is. It was packed full of young folks sampling the wares. Well, it's not for me. I'm far too set in my ways to be messing with the newfangled drinks. Hello. I'll find her eventually, maybe. There it is. Hola, make yourselves at home. And they're pretty Betsy. I think you can find a whole bunch of them here. I assume she's in one of the other places we've been to. Well, the owner's away, I'm looking after his home. Poor Discretia. Unfortunately, Senor Baldio is a very busy man. He never has time to visit this place. Still, you're welcome to look around. Mi casa es su... Well, you know what I mean. There is a book entitled The Complete Pomposo, an Architectural Masterclass, Volume 2. Tessa takes this off and has a closer look. It's packed with images of all the incredible buildings designed by Pomposo, along with detailed description. Cecily begins to feel dizzy and puts the book back. Okay, so it's the same book from earlier. They didn't change any books over the course of the years. Why must we work so hard when Senor Baljo's not even here? I decided to give myself the day off. Really? Very well. You may look around, but please do not make any mess. I do not want any work today. She decided to give herself the day off. That's how I was when I was a kid, too. A set of garish garb. When I was young, I had a bedtime of 10 o'clock. This has been about 8th grade at the time. So, one night my mom sends me to bed, and she comes out in the living room, and I'm back there playing video games again at about 10:20. And she's like, "What the hell? I sent you to bed." And I'm like, "Yeah, but I raised my bedtime." And she's like, "What?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm going to bed at 11 now." And then after that, she never bothered me. She just let me go to bed at 11. Mirrored. Yeah. Alright, so there's there is a fragment here, okay. Buenos dias, welcome to the final master, welcome to Seminario de Pomposa. The story goes that the greatest treasure of El Maestro is concealed at the top of this tower. Piero Querida. Dodo, watch out for the Lost Monstrous, the monsters. There are many who have come to live here over the years. You're welcome to research for the treasure of the tower, but I do not think you want you to hurt yourself. Alright, so before we do that, actually. I actually know that you can't go around this. There was treasure behind before, but it appears that's all been removed. Okay, now let's go in and see if we can climb to the top of this place. There's monsters here, so... Typical, no one thought to tell me there'd be monsters here. I can't do anything with those nasty things chasing after me. Maybe I'll knock the treasure hunter on the head and head home. There's a staircase in a room right at the back door. But I just can't work out how to open the door. Apparently it's got something to do with those different colored floor tiles, but I can't for the life of me figure it out. Okay, hang on a second. Oh, there's muscles on this floor. Oh, metal slime. What is this? Bad egg. Okay, good, it ran away. I was hoping I wouldn't run into metal slimes anymore. I do think I get EXP or job points here too, though. Alright, Ruff, do your stuff. Safe passage. How about I? What's this button do? Door is firmly locked. Okay, so we're probably have to step on both buttons. Yeah. Okay. Easy enough. You do have Undertale, and you should play it. Your friend bought it for you. Another metal slime. Man, so many metal slimes. I love metal slimes. I don't want to hurt them. Run away. No, don't stand attack. Alright, run away, metal slime. Thank you. I didn't say I bought it for you. Yeah. A bullet hell puzzle game? I don't know what. Oh shit. Okay. Moving ground. Moving pillars. Living pillars. Is this a boss fight? Alright. Thank you. Haha, it didn't work. Alright. Don't take my MP, you shit. Oh, fuck off. Jerks. Oh. They're boss music, but they're not really bosses. Hey, Ruffling Sap and Evac. Excellent. Pacifist route for defending against metal slimes. Oops. Yes, you do have Life is Strange as well. I'm pretty sure I gave you that. Alright, oh, that's a good crit. Yeah, this game does not want me to get through here. No, Cyril Slime, stop. No, metal slimes. Yeah, good. Run away. This is the one time in a game I will not want to fight metal slimes. Although the level limit on this place is 26, so... More living pillars. Alright, well, let's dump the crap out of these guys. Fuckers keep stealing my magic. Rude as shit. Serial killer appears in a grenade. Oh, I can deal with that. Let's heal up though. Through that one door. That's okay. Just led to a dead end anyway. Alright, what do we got here? A drop down, so let's drop down. Step on the blue button. Which then leads us back up. Okay, cool. We're on the third floor here. Sister examines the stone tablet in front of him. To quell the dragon's blazing might, give the beast the gift of sight. Okay. Jim's setting the dragon's eye socket. It looks like he could be able to pull it out. Ah, okay, I see what it means. Alright. I'll do leveling later. I don't need to actually... try and get into fights. Unfortunately, going down towards the screen, it's harder to see the monsters. See you later, bad egg. Ah! Sasori's level goes up. He learns a new spell, Frizzle. I don't think anybody knows Frizzle yet except Sasori, so cool. Attributes. Yay! His rank is swooping. He's a level 6 chimera. Shit. Alright. The enemy are defeated. There we go, defeated. Perfect. Yeah. A silk tuxedo! It's a good thing I came up here. Yeah, I'll pull out. Hi, Metal Slime. Don't worry, we're not gonna try and fight you, buddy. That's a new monster. We'll fight that, though. Slaying mantises. Ooh. They aren't that tough. 150 EXP though, not too bad. At least compared to what we have been fighting. Alright. So now we're on the fourth floor. Sasori examines the stone tablet in front of him. Four figures facing in shall show the way by which you'll go on or you'll onward go. Turns those three. I screwed this up. Give me a sec. Pretty sure I know what I have to do here, though. Okay, so looking at these, he turns face a certain way. Start with this one. Okay, so with these three facing this way. And that one facing north. Let's try. Okay. Now if I push this one once, that'll move it. And then if I hit it again, those two will be looking up, and that one will be looking to the left. Okay, so now, this one's looking to the left, this one's up, this one is in the center. Okay, so that one's not going to move this one. This one's already in place. So we're working on this one. So this one here, I have to push this button once more, and it'll turn this one to the center. This one will turn... Okay, I just got to push this button. Aha! My thoughts worked out. I don't like puzzles like that. Good thing I remember that from the PlayStation version, though. Cecil examines the stone tablet in front of him. Tread firm on all four signs to win. Your entire entry to the room within. I'm not sure I remember this room. Ah! That was just a gander on my part. I didn't think it'd actually be there. The stairs move out. A mini medal. Mi nombre es Antonio Pomposo, el maestro. This tower stands as a final testament to my genius that houses the greatest of all my treasures. But I am a private man, and I have no wish for the deepest parts of my soul to be known to the world at large. This is why I've designed a series of ingenious devices and contraptions to keep unworthy intruders at bay. But one day, in El Futuro, a brave adventurer touched with the same spirit of genius as myself will make it to this inner sanctum. To this adventure, I freely offer the treasures within the chests you see before you. But I would ask that you do not remove my two greatest treasures of all, the paintings that hang here. And please, do not tell a soul of the scenes they depict. I trust that you'll see fit to respect my final wishes. From one genius to another, I offer you my blessing. Another seed of wisdom. Hey, a green fragment. Yellow fragment. Alright. The painting is titled La Primavera. It shows two young men who look a lot like Pomposo and Salvador standing together with a young woman. They all look very happy indeed. The painting is titled Mi Quiera Hija. The girl in the picture looks very much like Antonia, the maid from the inn who you met in the past. Alright, so let's go get these yes, eh? Alright. Let's get out of this place first. Let's zoom to Pilchard Bay. We'll heal, save, reset our recording, and then head to the Shrine of Mysteries. Alright, here's our save point. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Your mother and father must be really confused because you're a chimera and not the fisherman's son that they raised. That they made, yeah. Indeed. The chimera just flies into their house and sleeps. Well, let's reset our recording, shall we? Make sure I didn't already do that. 39. Okay.